All right, new year, new you. I know a lot of us have New Year's resolutions, and one of them is a big one, decluttering everything, especially after the holidays when you get all the presents coming in.
Right. Yes, always at the top of everyone's list to get organized, isn't it?
Definitely.
Well, today I thought it would be fun to talk about three different quick tips that'll help you when you're moving into the new year. And the first one that I wanted to mention was getting your kitchen and your pantry decluttered. It's really easy. You know, they have all these great products now, like these little turntables. You know, you label everything and there's snacks in here. And then, you know, try to get things out of their packaging as much as you can and try to get them into these airtight. See how these pop?
Yeah.
And then this will keep all of your pasta and your cereal, your nuts, everything so much fresher. And then you also need space. Everyone needs space in their kitchen pantry or in their cupboards. So if you have a bunch of tea boxes, you know, that take up a bunch of space. So how, look at this. They all come out of the boxes and then they just go right in here and that just slides right on your shelf.
Perfect. So the big thing here, the takeaway is find little organizational things like this, cubbies, containers.
Really, it's just about the acrylic containers with the airtight seals and get everything, all the dry goods out of the boxes and get them into these containers if you can.
Mm-hmm. What about that'll saving make a big difference. Space? Right. Does this save space or is it?
It absolutely saves space. Well, think about when you have all those boxes of tea. I mean, this right here could take up an entire shelf in a cabinet because all those boxes are take up so much space. And even when you only have a few little, you know, bags of tea. So something like this is going to be really convenient because it just slides right in and then everything is out of the boxes. So when you get rid of the packaging in your kitchen and in your pantry, it makes an enormous difference.
Definitely.
You can't believe it. Yeah,
all right,
it's amazing.
Let's talk about the random miscellaneous stuff that we just have thrown in drawers, the junk drawer, right?
Oh, right, the junk drawer, right. Well, you know, the junk drawer, I have to tell you, every client that I work with, I insist that they have a junk drawer in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Because no matter what, everybody has stuff. You want to have a drawer that you can just open and throw stuff in. But if you can just at least get a drawer divider in there, it'll change everything. It makes all the difference. So then you have a little place for everything. I like to label everything because as you can imagine, I label everything. But this way, you know exactly what goes in which, and I actually did his and hers, which is kind of my favorite thing about a junk drawer. So these, you know, everybody has their own little space. And then I'll have another junk drawer where the kids can put their stuff.
What about all the paperwork for the junk drawer stuff?
Well, the paperwork, that's a whole different topic.
Yeah. Oh, gotcha.
We'll come in and talk about that another day.
All right, let's talk about clothing because that's probably my worst category is you try on outfits all morning long and then you're like, doesn't work. You don't have time to put that away.
No one has time to wear exactly. Well, you know, speaking of that, I actually have a suggestion when you've tried something on and it's not going to work and you don't have time and you can't put it away, then just try to have like a hook or two in your closet, just kind of put those back up. So you know, because if they end up on the ground, you're going to think, wait, is this dirty? Is this laundry? I don't know. But if it's on a hook, then you know that even though you didn't wear it, you still needs to be hung back up.
That's
so that'll help, I think, a little bit with that. Yeah,
so
for
talk
sure.
to us about the drawers.
Well, this is file folding, and I will tell you right now, this will change your life. And this is when you're taking all of your clothes, you're folding them like this, and you're putting them all in rainbow order in your drawers. So this whole drawer insert could go directly into a drawer, or you can just take your clothes and file fold them. See what you do when you're folding them like this.
Uh-huh.
They turn out to be like a little package like this, and it works out so great, and it's so much smaller. And when you put it into a drawer like this, then you can see what all the shirts are. Because, you know, everybody puts their drawers, they fold the laundry, they just dump them into the drawer. So then you have all your clothes that are up like this, so then you have to dig through them to see what you've got. But this way, with file folding, you can see exactly what every single thing is.
Perfect. Can you show us how to file fold really quick?
Oh, sure.
Do that?
Let's grab a shirt. You don't roll it, right? Look at that. Sacramento Kings.
Oh, perfect.
Look at that. That worked out. Okay. So file folding is absolutely will change your life. So you're just going to fold it out like this. I don't know if you can see. Fold it like this. You're going to fold it in. Fold it like this. Fold it in. You're basically making a little square. Like, that's the idea. So you're going to fold it in like this. And fold it in like this. And then one more. And then look. You have the idea is that you have it so it'll stand up just like that.
Perfect.
And then it folds right into... And you notice rainbow order. That really does make a big difference, rainbow order. And then it folds right in here like this, and you can see what all the shirts are.
Perfect.
So,
thank you so much.
It's a game changer, I tell you. It's a game changer.
Yeah, thanks, Kim, so much for everything and all your tips. Hopefully this can help for your tips as well for the new year and help you get a little bit more organized.